bitter situation, he has got a solution to every matter, that whatever you're going through, he is the answer to whatever. Okay, I want to bring it this way. As I wind up shortly, the land of the Bathutin, the land of the Mulun, and the land of Naphtali, the way of the sea, beyond the Jordan, Galilee of the Gentiles. And then he said, verse 16, the people who sat in darkness saw a great light, and upon those who sat in the region and the shadow of death, light has dawned on them. And I said, wale watu waliokaa walikuwa wamekaa chini ya giza, ama anasema chini ya uvuli wa mauti, sasa nuru kuu imewashukia. That really means kwamba the time has come when the law of grace is at work. It calls for a time that has come when you are enlightened. Unafundishwa, unafunguliwa kuelewa kwako, unapewa uwepesi wa kushika mambo ya Mungu, maswala ya ufalme. Light has come on them, those who are in great darkness. The people who dwell under the shadow of death, death was threatening all over. One was a Kuba, and then you are always fearing. Next is our family. Thank God, because nobody is going to die here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Nobody is going to die. The pastors already prayed over the issue. It doesn't matter. They lived under the shadow of death. But can we come to retrace? How did death come by? Kimo ilikujaje? Rudi pale nyuma. In the book of Genesis, chapter number 2. The Bible says, in the book of Genesis, I have like 2 minutes, then I go out of this place. Maybe the Lord will help you to understand. The Bible says in the book of Genesis, chapter number 2, verse number 17, it says, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat, for in the day that you shall eat of it, you shall surely die. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter number 2, verse 17, he says, Mungu mwenyewe anasema, okay, nimepeana uhuru wa kukula kila kitu. Kama niyo kukula basi. You see? But of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you shall not eat. Kumanisha, the time of mixing evil with good is not given to a church that has got identity of God living with her. Hallelujah. Yeah. Kanisa ambalo liko na kitambulisho ya Mungu anayekaa na yeye haina nafasi ya kuchanganya uzuri na ubaya, kuchanganya dhambi na utakatifu, kidogo hapa kidogo pale. You cannot mix, because he says when you mix, that one attracts death penalty, and that one calls for the law of death coming on you. But on the law of grace, which rather brings life, brings resuscitation, brings favor, brings acceptance to God, then it means no mixing, no eating, feeling evil. But so there was this law. God set a law that day that will bring death on human life, whether they will be there to obey or not. But he later brought a reversing factor, that coming of Jesus now reverses all things that really was meant for our death. Pengine kuna watu saa hizi kama sisi hapa tuwe kwa hai. Let me be conversant. Wacha tu niwe wazi. Useme tu kweli. Leo mimi kama si wokovu wa Yesu singekuwa hai leo. Na the pastor knows the story. Anajua wakati fulani nilishare na yeye akafikiria, you can look at me and say my life is like a movie. Kama filamu mtu anacheza sinema. If I tell you those things you can really wonder. Even huyu mtu amejunga tu kwa kiliani. But I tell you the real life issues ambayo mimi nimepitia, ambayo kwa kweli nakwambia saa hizi singekuwa hai. I remember one time I was in hospital, I shared with you. 9 months kwa hospitali Kenyatta. Ward D, 7 people tu. Mali watu natuwaka tayari wameenda mguni kama wako hai. 9D, kwa juu kabisa. I remember niliweka siku moja kwa room ya hewa, ya oxygen. Then, walikuwa nitame kusema, tuone kama ataendelea vibaya tumpeleke ICU. Wacha tumeke kwa hii isolation. Walikuwa akampa kitu kinacho anthrax, ile ugonjwa ya kushika ng'ombe, anthrax, no. Lakini mimi nilikuwa nimeumia tu. So they put me in isolation. I want to share with you this testimony. Mjue ya kwamba, okay, in the law,
to wait to see the blessings coming. They forget the blessing.
where he says, the lesser teaches us by his law to live godly life in this present age. Hallelujah. Ili kwamba tuepuke vitu ambavyo vinatuletea laana juu yetu. Verse 13, looking for the blessed hope. Now, you hear now? The blessedness. Okay? The blessed hope. Looking forward to the blessed hope and glorious appearing of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, we can say all amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Looking forward into the appearing of the Lord. Because the gospel in Jesus is going to target. Whenever it's been preached, okay, what in the Bible, Pastor, I know everyone is here knowing this thing. It has got a target. It must have a target. Must have a target. Not even given a lengo. Okay, how old are we? Where are we intending to take them? But rather to make sure that they have reached their goal someday. Because the Lord is going to appear in the glorious appearance that every man, every eye shall see him. And he says here that we are looking forward unto that hour when we are going to meet him in his appearance. Hallelujah. Thank you so much for sitting there and listen to it. I want to welcome the pastor to come and help us in prayer. Because I know there's some people who may need some help from this direction. Welcome so much, Pastor, as I go back down there. Appreciate you, God. Let's put our hands together to appreciate him. Let's appreciate him in a better way. Appreciate him in